Hello. Hi everyone. Good evening. Can all of you hear me? Okay, great. So welcome to IIMTS and thank you for attending my class today. Hope all of you are doing good and have a great day today. Prabha, can you hear me? Okay. Muhammad Abdul Seher. Seher, can you hear me? Dijesh, can you hear me? Okay, great. Ajit, can you hear me? Ajit, is my voice audible to you? Ajit, okay, great. Okay, so let's start with the class today. So the topic that we will be learning today is planning, the planning process in management in working environment, right? And how does it affect our decision-making process or our sorry, holiday schedule. What do we mean by planning? The term planning, how will you define planning? Everyone, according to you, what is the definition of planning in terms of MBA? Anyone? Everyone can give it a try. Planning the utilization of resources, resources, good. Designing any for good result, okay. Make a schedule what to do when and why, okay. Good. Wilfred has joined us. Wilfred, good evening. Can you hear me? Okay, so welcome to IIMTS, Wilfred, and thank you for attending the class today. So the topic that we are learning today is planning. Planning, we will also see strategic planning, what it is, right? So an act of drawing up layout for some project. Kelvin says, okay, good. Wilfred, you also want to try out the definition of planning? Okay. Let's see the process of development. Yes, that's true. Okay, let's see. Planning. It is the most fundamental function of management. It is the basic process of setting up goals to be reached and course of action to be followed. Now, all of us work in an organization, and all the organization have their goals set up, right? And we are just the tools or the elements or the manpower for fulfilling the goal set by the organization, right? So the path, so the blueprint of the path to be followed to achieve the goal set by the organization is known as planning, right? The best path which takes the least time and the least cost for achieving that goal set by the organization is called a planning. Clear? Am I right? Okay. Nazrullah Khan, hi. How are you? Welcome to IMTS. How are you doing? Third point. It is in fact a prerequisite. Shortcut to success. No, Wilfred. You cannot achieve a success every time with shortcuts. In some cases, it may be, right? It is the path, right? When the path to achieve the success, the path to achieve the goals set by your organization, right? Okay. Nazrullah Khan, the topic that we are studying today is planning. Okay, Nazrullah Khan and few others, Maria and Fahad, can both of you hear me? Okay, Maria, what about you? Okay, great. So good evening to both of you, Maria and Fahad, and welcome to IMTS. And thank you for attending my class today. So the topic that we are studying today is planning. Planning, strategic planning, right? Let's proceed. Thus, we can say planning is the management function of anticipating the future and the conscious determination of a future course of action to achieve the desired result, right? So the management set up the goals which is expected to be fulfilled in future, right? All the goals that the management set up take some time, right? It does not get fulfilled in a week or in a day, right? So the effort all the manpower of the organization will be putting it right to achieve that goal which is expected to give the outcome or the result in future, right? The best way to give your 100%, right, or to take out the best out of each employee who are working towards achieving that goal is termed as planning, right? And a plan is a predetermined course of action to be followed in future, right? So it is a early course of action, right? Which would be followed up in future. Planning is a process of forecasting the process of expected outcomes. Very good, Prabha. Yes, exactly. Not forecasting, but the way each manpower should work, the direction in which they should work, right, is also discussed, right? Okay, how many of you do planning before for doing anything in your day-to-day life or in your professional life? Have you set up your goals by yourself, or your manager, or your company management has given you the goals. Nasrullah Khan says, I do. Okay, what about others? Others don't plan. Dijesh says, I am doing it. Okay. Sometimes, okay. I just did it because I changed my job. Okay. Okay. Maria says, yes. For every activity needs a planning. Yes. Everyone does plan. Not, we are talking about professional life. Right. See, there is a thing called vision. Vision of your organization where you are working. The company has set some vision, some mission statement. Right. So how to achieve that mission statement? The company has predefined the roles of the employees working in the organization. They have given them some tasks, some time, some deadline. Right. And then your manager has done the planning. Who will work on which project or which team? How much time will it take to complete this task, that task? Right. And then the course of action is discussed in the weekly management meetings or monthly management meetings, right? Does it happens in everyone's organization or not? Okay, season for our organization just on. Every department works on plan, Maria says. Yes, very good. Without a plan, you cannot achieve the goals set by your organization. It's difficult. Now, nature of planning. Planning is purposeful, right? The planning that we are doing is for some purpose, right? Planning should not be purposeless. Right, planning should not be for fun or something like that. Right, it is a goal oriented. It is directed towards efficiency. Right, once we have a specific purpose, then only we can work behind achieving that purpose. Right, planning is a primary function. It is the basic level of management process. Right, so it is the basic of a management. Pervasive process. Many people believe in planning. It is the job of all the managers in all types of organizations, right? So I hope most of you are the managers of your departments or your organization, and many of you in future will become the manager, right? Then your job will be to manage the things, right? So for that, this planning skills is very, very important, right? You have to plan everything out, right? How will you utilize the skills of your teammates, right? So you have to plan accordingly. So that process is called persuasive process. Next is intellectual process. What do we mean by the term intellectual, everyone? What do we mean by the term intellectual? Everyone, at least you can give it a try. Everyone, it's a very common term, intellectual process, mental process. Okay. Thinking for betterment, Prabhasid, okay? Nasrullah Khan says idea, okay? Anyone else? See, intellectual process means thinking process. Right. Reggie says critical. Okay. Maria says skill, ability, clever. Yes, that's the correct word. Okay. a mental process involving imagination, foresight and sound adjustment, but not guesswork, right? So when we are planning, there should not be any guesswork, right? That for which each one of us are not sure, right? So our approach should be such that proper thinking process has been done for achieving the path or the goal set by your organization, right? Come up with sound solution. Yes, sound solution means effective solution, Prabha, if I'm not wrong. Okay, right. So for selecting or getting that effective solution, a thinking process is required, right? So one should always go through this intellectual process before planning any process or planning the steps to achieve the goals. Next is continuous process. Continuous means in continuity. An ongoing or dynamic exercise as old assumptions change, old plans are revised or new ones are prepared. Forward process, no plan can be prepared without knowledge of future, right? So we should, all of us should have the vision to think, at least not 100%, but 30-40%, that okay, if I follow this process, it will have this much impact in after 5 years or 10 years, which will be fruitful for our organization or power for ourselves. That is what we call a forward process. Next is involves the choice. Right? Decision making is the core of planning. Prabha says how to improve ourselves to do better use of intellectual decisions. See, it is a skill which comes up naturally, right? There are no classes or no courses for improving our intellectual skills. Each individual have their own intellectual level. Yes, experience. Yes, experience is one of the main factors. With time, once you go through. See what intellectual is. I will tell you exactly. I have a very strong feeling. Once you see in life, all of us go through a particular process, right? We fail once in that process. We fail twice in that process, right? If we are smart enough, we fail only once, right? Once we fail in doing anything, all of us have a strong habit or a human nature of thinking, right? Why do we fail, right? What could be the reasons, right? Now, what happens in life? In life, we have 50 to 100 scenarios, or maybe 150 or 200 scenarios, which comes up in everyone's life, right? What happens? Once we fail, we work on our weakness, and if that situation comes up again, we know how to face that situation, right? Similarly, when series of such things happen, that is what we call it as experience, right? So that once we face that situation the third time or the fourth time, right, it quickly clicks in our mind, okay, this is the situation, I have to deal this situation this particular way to bypass this situation or to succeed in this situation. That is what is called experience. That is the definition of experience, right? So once you have gone through that process, then your intellectual level will automatically go up. Am I right, everyone, or wrong? Or if others have any other idea, any other suggestion for Prabha? High thinking. Okay. Dijesh, what about you? What do you think? अजीत, विल्फ्रेड, एवरीवन प्लीज पार्टिसिपेट। मारिया, मारिया रिस्पॉन्डेड। ओके, have more knowledge. Yes, knowledge is also a factor. For getting more and more knowledge, you have to study a lot, read a lot. Right. All these things in a combined form increases an intellectual level of a person. Do research when you have time. Okay. Maria's Prabha, this is a suggestion for you from Maria. Do research, okay? That's a good idea. That's why they say knowledge is power, okay? Any other suggestions anyone has for increasing the intellectual power? Okay, let's proceed. Forward process we have done. Okay, let's move to the next slide. Now, a very important thing, objective. Objective for planning. Objective means the goal for planning. Why are we planning? What is the need for it? Okay, Mr. Sunil has joined. Sunil, good evening. How are you? Can you hear me? Okay, great. So welcome to IMTS and thank you for attending my class today. Hope you are doing good and have a great day today. So the topic that we are learning today is planning, strategic planning. Sunil, no issues, Sunil, right? You can go through the recorded class, right, of the part of the lecture you have missed, right? So you can continue. So we are just discussing the objective of planning. My worst is knowledge creates awareness. Yes, definitely. Anyways, so before starting the planning process, the objective should be clear in everyone's mind, right? Either the objective of your organization, right, which we call it as the vision of your organization or the mission statement of your organization, right? Once the objective is clear, either the objective is clear in your mind or your organization will keep pushing you or keep reminding you about the objectives, or your manager will keep reminding you, right, about the objectives. Because once the objective is clear, only then the path to be followed to achieve that objective is decided. And for that, this planning process is very important. Okay, so let's see. To focus attention on objective and results, right, one has to be sincere for their objective, right, because once the objective is decided and right, and once the team or individually we start working on achieving that objective, right, during the whole process we have to be very attentive and sincere. Only then we will only be able to achieve the results which we have forecasted or expected. Next point, any doubt so far anyone has or any questions? Okay. To reduce uncertainty and change. What do we mean by uncertainty? Not certain, right? Unstable, not stable, fluctuating, right? There should be no fluctuation, instability, uncertainty in one's mind, right? Regarding the goal. The goal should be 100% clear, either in an individual's mind of the goals we have individually set or the goals set by the organization, right? One goal chosen is chosen, right? We cannot switch between the goals, right? And then the whole team starts start putting the effort to achieve that goal. So there should be no uncertainty, and see, if there is uncertainty, our mind will fluctuate whether to go this way or that way, or to choose this goal or that goal, right? So it is very important to have the goals clear in the beginning only. Third point, to provide the sense of direction, right? Now see, the last topic that we have covered last week, there are multiple alternatives, right? And which alternatives do we choose, right? It depends on our skills. Similarly, once the objective is set, there are multiple ways or direction in which we can move to achieve that objective, right? Now we should have enough sense to go in the direction in which least time is consumed with least cost to achieve that goal. That is the aim of the organization, to achieve the goals in least time and less cost, right? So either if we are an individual or a manager, we follow that the directions. If we are an individual, our manager will address us to proceed in which manner, right? Or our management will guide us to proceed in which direction to achieve that goal, right? So direction is very important to save time, right? To work effectively. To encourage innovation and creativity, very important part. See, all of us should have a creative mind, right? What does it mean by creative over here? Or innovative mind, right? Like we used to say, out of box thinking, right? Now sometimes there are some solutions or some directions which is neither striking your manager's mind or your management's mind, right? Now if you have that level of creativity, your own idea, right, which you could suggest it to your manager or management, right, that sir, or that if we follow this process, it will be a beyond the approach. Yes, very good. Unique. Yes, correct. It will be a much better approach for fulfilling the objectives set by us, and it will be beneficial for the organization. Right now, if you do this thing, your individual reputation in the organization will go up, right? You will gain respect among your employees, right? And at a certain point of time, your management will consider you for a higher position, or it will help you in your promotion at that time, right? So such kind of thinking is always appreciated, right? And the best time to bring to the table these innovative ideas is during the weekly meetings or the monthly meetings of your organization, right? Where everyone, suppose if it is a small organization, everyone will sit in the same room and discuss about what is going in the organization, right? What difficulties are we facing at that time? If you shoot your ideas, right, it will directly reach to the higher management, right? Because sometimes what happens if you discuss your ideas alone to a few individuals, right, or to your manager, what they will do is they will hide your ideas from the management, right? They will try to project themselves that to the management that they are their own ideas, right? So these things also happen in organization, right? So it's also very important to choose the right platform to express your ideas, right? Okay, to help in coordination. To guide decision making, right? It helps in decision making to provide a basis for decentralization. What do we mean by decentralization, everyone? Does anyone have any idea what is decentralization? What do we mean by centralization? If anyone don't know decentralization. Everyone, at least you can give it a try. There's no harm in trying. Brijesh says decentralization to give work for all. Okay, very good point, Brijesh. Making more hubs, okay, to bring all together under one control is called centralization, Sunil. Okay, well tried. To control. Not up to the point, okay. See, centralization means everything will be controlled by a single body or a single individual, right? Every decision will be taken by the single body. Every approval needs to be taken from that authorized single body, right? That is called centralization, right? Where there is one boss or one boss department, right? From where we have to take all approvals and everything, right? Decentralization means dividing your powers among the individuals or among the teams, right? So that they can themselves take the decision which will save the organization's time, and no time will be wasted in taking the permissions and all those stuffs. Getting my point? Right, so for this, with the help of planning, the roles will be distributed among the teams, and each member of will be allocated a job role and the designation. Right now, it is the headache of that individual. How will he perform or give the output? Right. So it will definitely save time. This is what is happening in the private firms these days. Everything is getting decentralized. Right, and that's why performance has become the main parameter for sustaining in the organization. Clear, everyone? Any doubts so far? Okay, next is to provide economy in operation. Next is to facilitate the control, not as important. Okay, this is 1B50, 1 second. Now let's come to the strategic planning. What do we mean by strategic planning? Planning we have done. Any idea what do we mean by strategic planning? Yes, to achieve goal, clear planning to achieve the goals, a long-term plan. Okay, well tried. Let's see what strategic planning is. This is where I'm going to leave it. learning objectives. If you will be learned by the end of this PPT, yes. Now, what is strategic planning? It is used by a community of groups, government departments, organizations, and businesses to develop a blueprint for action and change. Right? Strategic planning means making a strategy, right, on a course of action, right, to grow the business or take the organizations forward, right? The process should be community based, inclusive, and participatory to allow for maximum stakeholder involvement and input. Clear, everyone? Sahel, are you following? Sahel Shakur. Okay, good. Now let's see the benefits of strategic planning. It defines the mission, which is called the mission statement of the organization, the vision of the organization, and the ethical and moral values of the organization. Right, the values on which the organization is running, right, or the values at which the organization is set up, right, establishes the realistic goals, objectives, and strategies. Right, so with the help of this strategic planning, the organization sets up the realistic goals means the goals which can be achieved, right? The objectives and the strategies achievable, yes, and the strategies for achieving that goal. Strategic planning ensures effective use of resources, right? So for achieving the goals or the vision or the mission, resources are an important part. Now, how do you effectively use the resources, right? So that they can give their best, right, and give their and work with 100% efficiency, right, comes under strategic planning. Right, with the help of a strategic planning, we can effectively use our resources. Provides a base to measure the progress. Right, with the help of strategic planning, we can measure the progress from time to time, right, and self introspect that whether we are going in the correct direction, at correct pace, at correct financial conditions or not, right? Develops consensus on future direction, builds a strong team, and solves major problems. So these are some of the benefits of strategic planning. Well, let's see the types of planning. One is strategic planning, one is business planning, one is project planning, one is program planning, one is municipal planning, and planning as a profession. We have some professional planners, planning functions in other professions, not as important. Okay, let's try this exercise, everyone. To discuss how personality affects how groups work together to develop a strategic plan or any type of plan. These exercises you can try it at the end of the class, right? There are 3 to 4 exercises, right? I will ask the coordinator to upload this PPT on your LMS, right? So from there you can practice these questions, right? Exercises. Because only 15 minutes are left. Now let's see the strategic planning models. Type of organization usually dictates the type of strategic planning. We have a non-profit, right? Non support organizations are non taxable organizations, right? And they don't pay the taxes to the government because the cause for which they are running is for the betterment of the society or public related job they are doing. Right, so those type of organizations are called non-profit organizations. Likely focus on board development, management, fundraising, and policies. Right, for profit, likely focuses on profit and strategic directions. Now, next is the types of strategic planning. We have basic strategic planning. We have issue-based or goals-based strategic planning. We have alignment model. We have scenario planning. And we have organic or self-organizing planning. These are the five types of strategic planning. Any doubt so far? Anyone else? Okay. Now, next is planning to plan. Planning to plan requires now planning to plan means the phase or the time before you start planning. That is the phase. That phase is called planning to plan. It requires organizational readiness. It means that you should be aware of all the verticals of your organization, right? Recognition of need to plan, right? For that, you should the vision and the organization or organizational goals should be clear to you. That is called recognition of need to plan, whether the need is there for planning or not. Commitment to plan, that you should give your 100% at the time of planning. Then we have organizational commitment. For that, the board and volunteer commitment is required. The staff commitment for achieving the goals of the organization is also required. Then organizational capacity, in that the human resources, the staff, the volunteers, the board committees, the special or standing committees are assigned the goals or the functions, right? Then we have the financial resources for which we have to identify the budget. We have to determine the resources and the time. Time is very important, right? We should break our goals into sub-goals and set up the deadline for it. So for that, we have to allocate the time, allocate organizational time, determine realistic timelines. Now the reasons for strategic planning: change, renewal, funding requirement, financial forecasting, the mandate, build consensus, improve staff and board relations, develop ownership, build community support, and others. These are the reasons for strategic planning. Let's answer this question, everyone. Why do you want to engage in strategic planning? Answer this question, everyone, in the chat box. Let's see how far you have understood. Everyone, why do you want to engage in strategic planning? We should have a goal first, okay? It gives us a clear picture and the steps to follow the at your goals, okay? Good point, to achieve the goals, okay? Good point. What about others? Maria says to plan accordingly and achieve the goals. Okay. Kelvin says because it lays down the pathway to organizational objective. Yes, very good point. What about others? Dijesh says achieving the goal. Okay. Good point. Okay, Muhammad Abdul Hafi says achieving goals by utilizing the full of resources. Yes. Very good point. Rezi says strategic planning will give the clear idea about organizational objective, which will help to set our personal objectives. Okay, yes, that's true. Okay, good. Now let's see the strategic planning process. So first is planning to plan. In this way, we will first make the planning team, strategic planning team, right? We have to decide the team. We will have the board, the staff, the community volunteers, right? Then we have the strategic planning budget, right? We have to establish the budget, identify the funding resources. So we'll give funds for our goals. Then we need the strategic planning facilitators, right? We have to identify a facilitator to lead the process, right? Who will monitor the whole process, right? Then we have the strategic planning partners, right? In this we have the internal board and staff. We have the external community groups or governments or departments or other departments. Let's see what happens in. These are the steps, right? 1, 2, 3, 4 for this process. Now let's see each one of them in detail. Developing the plan means mission. We have to first decide the mission of the objective, core purpose of your organization or the vision of your organization. Presented in a clear short statement that focuses on attention in one clear direction by stating the purpose of the group's uniqueness. Right, so every resource should be aware of the goals or the vision or the mission of the organization. Vision, what is your organization's vision of excellence? Has to be realistic and not something impractical. Then the values, moral and ethical values of your organization. What are the principles, standards and actions considered worthwhile in the organization? Includes how people treat each other, how groups conduct business and what is most important to the organization. Then we have the strategic analysis, environmental scan, gathering of information that concerns the organization's environment, analysis and interpretation of this information, application of this analyze information in decision making. Clear, everyone? Any doubt so far? Okay, Prabha has the question. What is the difference between vision and mission? A very good question. Anyone would like to answer? Okay, Maria says vision is to see yourself in future. Maria, she is asking from the organization's perspective, not personal perspective. Anyway, let's see. Good, well tried, Maria. Anyways. Okay, mission actually give a clear cut to a vision statement where you would be your course and in the future. Vision is the destination to reach and mission is to implement. Okay, very good points. Let's see the definition. Vision is how you see the goal. Mission is what you are going to achieve. Very good point, Abdul. The mission statement concentrates on the present. It defines the customer's critical process and it informs you about the desired level of performance. The vision statement focuses on the future. It is a source of inspiration and motivation. Often it describes not just the future of the organization, but the future of the industry or society in which the organization hopes to affect the change. You can see this link. I found this beautiful link. Right. You can see this link and compare mission statement with vision statement based on various parameters like about, answer, time, function, change, developing a statement, features of an effective statement. Right. Can all of you see? Right, so this is a very good link. Prabha, clear? Maria, clear? Okay. Then we have the SWOT analysis. All of you know SWOT analysis, strength, weakness. Strength means what are some internal positive things about your organization, what does the community see as your strength, weakness, what are the weaknesses in your organization, what does the community see as your weakness. Then O means opportunity, what are some opportunities in your community or region. Right, and T means threat. What are some provincial or national issues facing the organization? What are some technology issues that face the organization? Like that. Right, then developing the plan for that goals. Identify long-term outcomes to provide focus for the planning process. Then strategies, outline how will you achieve your goals. Objectives, identify the specific measurable results produced while implementing the strategies. Goals and objectives should be smarter, specific, measurable, acceptable, realistic, time frame means all goals should have a deadline, extending and rewarding. Then we have the implementation, right? Once the goals are set, blueprint is made, we have to start implementing tasks assigned to various board and staff responsible for specific items. Right? We will allocate the tasks, timelines established for implementation of the plan for implementation, funding the plan, what is required. Then, Maria, my class is from Monday to Friday, right? On Monday, I have the class at 8 p.m. your time, 8, 9:30. Yeah. Monday, Tuesday, 8 p.m. Wednesday, Thursday, 7 p.m. and Friday, 6 p.m. Clear, Maria? Monday, Tuesday. Eight PM. Wednesday, Thursday, 7 PM and Friday, 7:30, yeah, 6 PM. Yes, probably we will have accounting classes as well each week, either one or two classes. I will try to take two accounting classes out of five each week. Sure. Clear, Maria? Are all of you enjoying my classes? Or is it boring? You are better than before. Okay, thank you. Maria, you can take the class from your office only, right? You can finish the class and then leave the office. Thank you, Abdul. Thank you for your compliment. Right, so you have to manage somehow, Maria, right? Either you can take the class from your office. Right, you can put your headphones in the office and you just have to listen to the lecture, right? You don't have to speak. So if you can manage it in your office, it will be good, right? Otherwise, you have to make some alternative. You can try it once. I hope it will work, right? There is some cabin in your office which is quiet, where there is no noise. Like, you can sit over there, or you can sit in the library or reading room or conference room, something like that. You can inform your manager that I have the class in the evening, so allow me to take one class. I hope they won't mind. Right? So I think we can stop over here today. We will continue it tomorrow same time, right? It depends, right? There is no harm in employing. You are studying, it will tell them that you are doing MBA, right? It will add value to your profile, right? It will not degrade your, right? So frankly speaking, it's indirectly a good way of communicating, of knowing your management that you are doing MBA, right? There is no harm. Right. So anyways, it's up to you. It's you. Right. So thank you everyone for coming to my class today. Thank you very much. Good night. Take care. See you tomorrow. Right. And please fill the feedback form at the end of your class. Yes, Sunil. Very good point.